we are doing more elimination problems similar to the ones that we saw in the previous lesson, except this time they're going to be just a little bit harder. So what we're doing today is elimination that requires multiplication. So our objective is to solve systems of equations using the elimination method. So yesterday, all of the ones that we saw had your x or your y, and they had the same number in front of them. And so you could just add them or subtract them to get one of your variables to cancel out. So now we have the question, what if there are no common coefficients? What if you don't have an x that has the same number in front or a y that has the same number in front? So our solution is going to be to multiply one or both equations by some number to create your matching or your opposite coefficients. So we'll see what we mean when we do this first example. So here we have x plus 3y equals 6, and 2x minus 7y equals negative 1. Okay, do your x's have the same number in front of them? No. Do your y's have the same number in front of them? No. In order to eliminate something, we need one of our equations or one of our variables to have the same number in front. So how do we get x to have the same number in front? Well, this x has a 2. So we would like the other one to also have a 2. And we know in order for it to cancel, we need one positive and one negative. So what we're going to do is we're going to multiply this entire first equation by negative 2. And you're going to multiply that negative 2, you kind of distribute, you send it to every single piece. So every piece gets multiplied by negative 2. That's going to give negative 2x minus 6y equals negative 12. Our second equation, we're going to copy down exactly the same as it is. 2x minus 7y equals negative 1. Don't change anything. Now what we notice is that now your x's can cancel. So what happens when we add them together? X's cancel. Negative 6y minus 7y is negative 13y. That equals negative 13. How do we finish solving for y? Divide by negative 13, and we get y equals 1. Okay, are we done yet? No, we need to remember that we always have to get an x and a y. So now we're going to take this 1, and I'm going to go back to that first equation that we have before we changed it, and I'm going to plug 1 in for y. Doesn't matter which equation I plug that 1 into. No, I could pick this one, or I could pick this one, or I could even pick the new one. It doesn't matter what I plug y into, it should all give me the same answer. So let's replace that y with a 1 and use that to solve for x. X plus 3 equals 6. Subtract 3 from both sides, we get x equals 3. So our solution is 3, 1. Okay, we're going to do a few more examples. They're all going to be kind of the same idea, so if you would like to at any point, you can pause the video, try it on your own first, and then hit play again to check yourself. Okay, let's look at number 2 here. So which variable is easier to cancel? Look for one that doesn't have a number in front of it. That's going to be the easiest thing to cancel. So we know that this has a 3, so I know I need a negative 3 to get them to cancel, so multiply the bottom equation by negative 3. I'm going to keep the top equation exactly the same. 9x plus 3y equals 12. Negative 3 times 2x is negative 6x. Negative 3 times y, negative 3y. And negative 3 times 5 is negative 15. Now let's add those together. What happens with our x's? 9x minus 6x is 3x. What happens with the y's? They cancel out. Equal to what is 12 minus 15? Negative 3. Finish solving for x, divide by 3. X equals negative 1. Are we done yet? No, remember, we still have to go find out what y is. So now I just picked the equation that has smaller numbers. So the second one looks like it has smaller numbers. So let's substitute that negative 1 into our second equation. So we had 2x plus y equals 5, so we replace this x with negative 1 since we know over here that x equals negative 1. That gives us negative 2 plus y equals 5. How do we finish solving for y? Add 2 to both sides, y equals 7. And so our solution is negative 1, 7. Okay, let's do another example. Which variable should we eliminate? Well, this y doesn't have a number in front of it, so that's going to be an easy choice. This y has a 4 in front of it, so we need the first one to have a 4. We already have a positive and a negative, so we'll just multiply by positive 4 because I don't need to get to a negative. So when we multiply that by positive 4, 4 times 3x is 12x. 4 times negative y is negative 4y. 4 times 14 gives us 56. And copy down our second equation exactly the same. 5x plus 4y equals 12. Now let's add those together. 12 plus 15 is 17x. Y's cancel out. Over here, 56 plus 12 gets 68. Divide both sides by 17, and we'll see that x equals 4. Now we need to find y. We'll go to our first equation, plug in 3x minus y equals 14. I know that x equals 4, so we're going to have 3 times 4 minus y equals 14. So 12 minus y equals 14. How do we solve for y? Subtract 12, negative y equals 2, divide by negative 1, so y equals negative 2. Write our solution as a point, 4, negative 2. All right, let's go to our next example. We'll switch colors just for fun. Okay, which variable should we eliminate? Well, in this case, x doesn't have a number in front of it, and y doesn't have a number in front of it either. So either one of those would be easy to eliminate. So the next thing that helps me decide is which one has a positive and a negative on it. So x's, in this case, are both positive. I already have a positive y and a negative y, so I'm going to choose to eliminate y. Now, really, it doesn't matter. You could eliminate either variable. So just kind of make your choice. So let's eliminate the y. This one has a negative 2, so I need this to have a positive 2. I already have the positive. Multiply by 2, and that's going to give us 2x plus 2y equals negative 6. Copy it down the second equation the same way, and let's add them together. 2x plus 5x is 7x. Your y's cancel out. And then on the right side, we get negative 56. How do we finish solving? Need to get x by itself, so get rid of that 7 by dividing, since that's the opposite of multiplication. We get x equals negative 8. Go back to that first equation, x plus y equals negative 3, and plug in this negative 8, so negative 8 plus y equals negative 3. How do we solve for y? Add 8 to both sides, and we get y equals 5. So our solution is negative 8, 5. And make sure when you write the solution, it's always x first and then y. And what this means is if I took this x and this y, if I wanted to check my answer, I could plug it in. Negative 8 plus 5 is negative 3. 5 times negative 8 minus 2 times 5 does equal negative 50. So that's how we would check. All right, let's do one more example. What's going to be easier to eliminate in this case? Well, this y doesn't have a number in front of it, so let's eliminate the y. I have a negative 3 up here, so now I need the opposite. I need a positive 3y. This is negative, so to get to a positive 3, I need to multiply by negative 3. So my first equation just stays the same. 3x minus 3y equals negative 3. In the second equation, multiply every piece by negative 3. So 2x times negative 3 is negative 6x. Negative y times negative 3 is positive 3y. Negative 5 times negative 3 is positive 15. Okay, what do we do next? let's add those equations together. 3x minus 6x is negative 3x. Negative 3y plus 3y, those cancel out. That's going to be equal to negative 3 plus 15 is 12. How do we finish solving for x? Divide both sides by negative 3, and we get x equals negative 4. Are we done? Nope, we still need to find y. So we know that 2x minus y equals negative 5. So 2 times negative 4, coming from here, minus y equals negative 5. Negative 8, then minus y equals negative 5. Add 8 to both sides. Negative y equals 3. So y equals negative 3 after you divide both sides by negative 1. So our solution is negative 4, negative 3. Let's do a quick check. Let's make sure we got it right. Okay. I have 3x minus 3y equals negative 3, which means that I should have 3, and if I plug in my x from my answer, negative 4, and I plug in the negative 3 for y from our answer, it should come out to be something that's true. So 3 times negative 4 is negative 12. Negative 3 times negative 3 is 9. Is that equal to negative 3? Negative 12 plus 9 is negative 3. We get negative 3 equals negative 3, which is good. Okay, so it worked in that case. In order for it to be the solution, it has to work in both equations. So now, let's check the second equation. We have 2x minus y equals negative 5. So we would have 2, replace x with negative 4 from our solution, minus, replace y with the negative 3 from our solution, equals negative 5. And let's see if this statement is true. 2 times negative 4 is negative 8. Negative negative 3 becomes positive 3. Negative 8 plus 3, we get negative 5 equals negative 5. That is true. And so since both equations came out to be true, I know that this is, in fact, the solution. So we've checked it. We've verified that it works. That brings us to the end of our example and also the end of our lesson for today. Thanks for watching.